Hi all, welcome to Hello World series. Today we will see how we should encrypt password while using Maven to deploy any web application into Tomcat. So the problem is, in the last few tutorials we have been seeing that we can use Apache Maven Tomcat plugin to deploy a web application into Tomcat. So this is what we have done in our settings.xml of Maven. We had given server configuration with ID, username and password. If you see here, the password is a plain text password, right? So this is the main problem. So why should I encrypt any password? Because plain text passwords are not safe, and there could be a set of users who are using the same machine for building your application or deployment into some server. It could be a continuous integration Jenkins box or any other server, and I may not want everyone to be a part of deployment group, and I want to limit that to a few users. So for all those reasons, I should look forward to encrypt password while using Maven. So what we can do to overcome this problem? First solution is encrypt the password. Second solution, which will always have level 1 solution also. So level 2 solution will be encrypting a password plus keep that encrypted password on some removable drive like flash drive or pen drive. So if you would have seen nowadays or for a long time, whenever you connect to VPN connection, you need to carry a device sometimes, right? Nowadays it's more of a software, but many people still use one device which generates 6-digit number. So the similar way, we can also keep our encrypted password on some drive which user can always carry, is like external drive, which could be a flash drive or external drive or something else, right? So these are the two level of solutions we can adopt to solve this problem. Now, we will talk less and we will do more. So let's see a demo where we will encrypt master password. We'll talk about what is master password, and then we will encrypt password to deploy our web application into Tomcat, and we'll store our master password into a new file which is settings-security.xml. We will also see where we can keep this file. And we will update settings.xml of Maven with our Tomcat password, which is encrypted one. Then we will create a sample web application. We have been doing that for a long time. And then we have to make changes to pom.xml of our new sample web application so that it will know that it is going to use Apache Maven Tomcat plugin for deployment. And then we will deploy our web application to Tomcat. And finally, we'll verify whether our application is being deployed into Tomcat or not. And we'll try to modify the encrypted password, and we'll see whether it still works. It should not work. If I change the password, it should not work, because it will be like an encrypted password. So if I try to modify that, my system will not accept it. So we'll verify all those scenarios, and we will verify whether our application works in Tomcat or not. And this is all. So let's go back to demo and we will verify all these. So encrypt master password, we'll use some command from Maven, that is -emp, and let me type some password. This is not specific my master password or my password or anything. It could be anything what you want. Okay, so let's encrypt this master password. Maven is encrypting. So this complete password is your encrypted master password. So don't think that password inside this curly braces is the only password. This complete string is password. Okay, and this is master password basically. Now, what is the master password? By master password, I mean that Maven will use this master password to encrypt other passwords. and other passwords could be like Tomcat deployment password, right? So EMP is encrypt master password and EP is encrypt password. As you have seen that we used password as Tomcat deployment password for admin user, right? So let me encrypt it. And this is the way, right? This is the way it generated my normal password also. So now I've got two passwords. So this password, master password, I need to keep in settings-security.xml under .m2. And this password I can keep in my Maven installation conf settings.xml. So let's go back and modify those files. So we have encrypted master password. We have encrypted our normal Tomcat password also. So now we have to create settings-security.xml and we have to also update settings.xml. So go to your favorite editor and create a new file with this content, which has only two tags. The parent tag is settings security and the child tag is master. So this master tag will contain our master password, which is encrypted. We just encrypted some time back. So let's use that password. So let's copy this and paste it here. Now let's go back and save this file into .m2. So let's go to .m2 folder of Maven and save this file as settings-security.xml. Now open settings.xml from your Maven installation. This is the file, and you know that we already use password to connect to Tomcat server, but this is a plain text password. So what we'll do is we'll use encrypted password what we just generated from command prompt. So this is the password we are going to use and keep it into settings.xml password. So update plain text password with encrypted password. So we have also completed step 3 and step 4. Now let's create sample web application. This is a simple application which we have been using for a long time. Let's run this command. It is created. So this new application is created. Now let's go to this application. Step number 5 is also finished. Now let's make changes to pom.xml of this sample web application. Go to this directory. Here is the pom.xml. Now we have to update this build tag with plugins. We have been doing that for a long time in our last tutorials. So there is nothing new. This is just to tell this pom.xml that you can go and use Apache Tomcat Maven plugin, which I'm going to use for deployment. So this is the configuration for that plugin. This is the URL of Tomcat admin console. And server is Tomcat server, which is configured as ID in our settings.xml. And this is the path. So let's save that. So now step 6 is also completed. So let's go back to our Tomcat, start Tomcat, and try deploying this web application, which we already did in our last tutorial. So let's do it again. So this is the bin directory of Tomcat. Let's start. Tomcat is started. Now we are already in the new directory, which we created as a sample web application. So run this command to deploy our web application into Tomcat. It works fine. So you can see it deployed this web application. Now let's change the password which we just encrypted and see whether it works or not. Our assumption is it should not work. Let's verify. So we just deployed our application, so let us undeploy this first, and this undeployment should fail. It failed. Let's see what's the error. It says 401 unauthorized, which is perfectly fine because we just tried to modify the password. Now let us undo that and try one more time. This time this should be undeployed. Undeploying, and this is done. So okay, everything is fine. Now let us deploy again. Deployed again, right? So you saw that once we give the correct encrypted password, deployment works. If we just try to modify the real password with something else, it fails. So it proves that our encrypted password mechanism is working. Now, as we have already deployed this application, so let us verify from browser whether it's working or not. So once you log in into console of Tomcat, you can see that these are all your applications, and this is one of the application which we just deployed using Maven Tomcat plugin with encrypted password. So let's go inside, and it shows hello world. So you could just verify that all your deployment is working, your applications are running fine with encryption, and this is all what we wanted to achieve in this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you really like this video, you can like this video on YouTube. Or you can also subscribe to my channel, and just keep your email preferences on while subscribing so that you will receive all the updates whenever I upload a new video on this channel. Thank you so much for watching.